Hello everyone, our today's topic is still life in a pencil shading. Let's see the material required for the drawing. Drawing pencils HB to 8B, eraser, clutch pencil, long scale, 1/4 side drawing paper or a drawing book. First, we are going to draw 1 cm borderline to a page, write down the heading on the left hand corner, write down today's date. Then we are going to start the drawing. First, take a 2-finger distance, that is approximately 3 cm distance from the upper side, upper borderline. And then we are going to start on a drawing. From exactly middle, we start taking one point and draw one line on the left hand side to draw on a cube, which is exactly in the middle of this page. Rectangle cube has a size of approximately 8 to 10 cm in height, and it's facing toward on a right hand side part. The rectangle is putting on a one base, and this base is wrapped with the drapery. Now from the exactly middle of the rectangle, we start making a hexagon cone, which is approximately the size of the rectangle, that is 8 to 10 cm in height, and it's facing three sides. Now we continue this line to the left hand side part, and slightly on a lower side we draw another cone, which is also an approximately 8 to 10 cm in height, that is exactly same as on a rectangle, and this is on a cone. Now we draw on a hexagon. First we draw on a square, then continue the lines to the back side. Same angle of the line we copied on the back side. Divide this square in two parts, then join with the two cross lines to join four edges of the square on both the sides, front and back. Now join all the six points of the hexagon from front and back side to make exact hexagon. This is our full drawing of the objects. We are using geometrical objects here, like cube, cone, hexagon, hexagon cone, everything we use here. This is our white drapery that we use here, and these are the folds for the white drapery we are putting on the surface. On this drapery we put over all the objects for the still life. In background also there is a drapery, white drapery we use. This is also the fold for the draperies we showing here. These are the folds, the hanging drapery, and there are some folds also there for the drapery that we are going to show it here by folding the lines. These are the all drawings. Now finally the drawing with the 2B pencil, and then we are going to start the shading. Erase all unnecessary rough lines, and then we finalize with the 2B pencil, and then we start with the shading, pencil shading. For that we use a drawing pencils of HB to 8B. There are many qualities of the drawing pencils are available in the market. I am using here Artline pencil of drawing, and which is a very much good quality. You can use Staedtler pencil or the Domes or the Camlin, Faber-Castell. There are many brands in the market that you can use for the shading. Here I am rubbing all the unnecessary and rough lines. This is our final drawing. Now let's start the shading. Here the lights is come from the left hand side part, that's why this rectangle cube has a 3 dimension, light, middle and dark. This is our upper side, middle part, middle shade we are going to shade it with the 2B pencil. Now I am taking all the pencils HB, 2B, 4B, 6B, 8B from the box. We are not directly use the higher B pencil like 4B, 6B, 8B here. First we start with the 2B pencil and then overlap the shades of the 4B and 6B pencil to darken our shades. Here I am using a cross hatching technique of the pencil shading. For that first we apply on a 2B pencil application with one direction, one cross direction. Then for the darkened tone, same 2B pencil I am using in another direction so that it gets a darkened tone. And afterward, if I want more darkened tone, then I use 4B pencil for the more darkened tone. I'm not directly use on a 4B or 6B pencil here, so that it gets darkened. I'm using cross etching technique. First apply one cross tone, then again apply on a same 2B pencil with different direction tone, so that it gets on a darkened tone. Now you can see I am applying on a one tone of the 2B pencil in cross direction all over the surface. You have to hold a pencil cross angle so that the tip of the pencil you can touch it on a surface. Now this is on a second angle of the application with the 2B pencil, and we get on a slightly darkened tone here. You can see easily here. So with the same pressure I apply on a shading here. There are different techniques of the pencil shadings are there, like some are using a cross etching technique, some are using scribbling techniques, some of them are directly used on a exact shades of the pencil like 2B, 4B, 6B, 8B, 10B pencil for direct tones with the same pressure. But this is a perfect technique for your pencil shading, cross etching technique, which gets a proper effect, proper shades of the objects, as well as this is a step by step technique. That's why you get a proper shades, light, middle, dark, in a step by step manner. If you directly apply on a 4B, 6B pencil, sometimes it gets darker, sometimes it gets lighter, so you get confused. That's why I suggest you to use this technique for your shading, so that it gets on a proper tones. Now you can see here we get on a three tones are here, light, middle and dark. If you want to apply more darkened tone here, you have to use 4B pencil, so you get on a more darkened tone here. I think this is a comfortable for our object. This is on a wooden object. It's slightly on a yellow ochreish brown color in a shade, so I think we are very much comfortable about this tone, and we can make our proper tone with application of 2B and 4B pencil. We start next object with the hexagon cone. It has a three dimensions, light, middle and dark. The first part we left with the white tone. On a second part we apply on a one tone with the 2B pencil, which is in a middle tone, and third part we apply on a dark tone, which is opposite side of the light, and that's why it's on a dark tone. Here is I am applying on a 2B pencil one tone, which is a middle tone, which is we already apply on upper side of the rectangle cube. You can very clearly identify the tones. Now this is on a dark tone. For that, first I apply one 2B pencil application, and then I apply on a second tone with the darken, which is on a dark tone. If you have on a proper handling of the pencil, you can directly apply on a tone with a 2B pencil. I have on a practice of applications of the handling of the pencil, that's why I can directly apply on a dark tone on this surface. But you are the beginner, that's why I am suggest you to apply on a two tones of the 2B pencil, so it gets on a darkened tone. Now this part is a more toward on a right hand side part, that's why it's more darkened than this cubical darkened tone. That's why I suggest you to apply more darkened in comparatively to the cube. So I am using 4B pencil for the second application here, and you can clearly see we get on a darkened tone on this surface while applying on a 4B pencil application. I am using two applications of 4B tones on this application part, so that it gets on a darkened than this cubical darkened tone. Now the edge of the objects also gets darkened. Here I apply more darkened tone for the cube on upper side because of some edge. which starts with the hexagon. This surface gets on a middle tone because it's on a upper side and lights comes from the left hand side part, so it gets on a middle tone. Now here we get on a more than three tones, middle and two dark tones. This is a lighter dark tone, and on a third surface we get on a darker dark tone. This is exactly, or we can say slightly similar to the middle tone of the cone hexagon, and slightly darker than middle tone of cone hexagon. That's why applying on a two applications of 2B pencil here, so that it gets on a similar tone of the dark tone which is we get in a cube. Now on a darker tone I am directly apply on a 4B pencil because it's more darker than all parts of the objects. That's why I apply an application of 4B pencil here, so that which gets on a darker tone, and we require 2 to 3 applications of this 4B pencil so that we get on a proper dark tone. This is first application. Now I am taking on a 6B pencil for this to get on a darker tone, and I apply on a one application of 6B to get on a darker tone. Like that we make shading on a cone also. We require 3 tones of the light, middle and dark, and also on a drapery also we have to work so that we get on a 3 tones of the lights, light, middle and dark. This front part we left with the paper white so that it gets on a lighter tone. Some edge part we shaded so that it gets an effect of the wooden surface. Here I am going to show on a shadow of this cone hexagon on this hexagon surface, upper surface, so that we get on a shadow. This is on a drapery. For that we apply on a 3 tones, light, middle and dark. First we apply full 2B application on the background surface, then add some darkness, and on a depth we apply 4B and 6B pencil to add more darkness. Also on a cone also you can see we apply 3 tones. Now the same technique we use in a drapery, which is we put on a base part, we apply 3 tones. Also we make on a shadow. This is in a shadow of the cone which is showing on a drapery. You can see how we are going to show this. In any one direction we first we apply on a tone, and then look how we show on a shadow. This is the way you have to show on a shadow. This is the exact way you have to apply on a shadow. The darkened surface is on a edge, and when it goes away it gets fade out. The nearer part is dark. The object is touching on a surface, it gets on a darkened tone, and when it goes away, the shadow goes on a lighter. Here also we get on a same tone that we have applied on a cube, because this is exact same surface which is on the same side of the darkened surface of the cube. So you have to apply same tone to this application on this surface, but the application is different because this drapery has a fold, so you have to apply an application in 2-3 directions. The way drapery is fold mold, you have to apply an application of the pencils. If you have a problem to identify the exact tone of the object in pencil shading, you can take a black and white photo of the any object and you can get a proper tone of the black and white shades, light, dark, middle, whatever tone you have, and you can refer this photo to make pencil shading. This is for the beginners who is apply on a pencil shading, but for the professional you have to judge a tone by your own. This is a perfect technique for your pencil shading. This is in a darkened tone for the folds. You can see there is this drapery as in a folds, and we can easily see the darkened tones also, how the draperies are fold. We can show in these techniques. While doing on a pencil shading, you have to learn on a texture of the surface also. Like these objects are wooden objects, drapery is a cotton drapery, so the textures of the all objects are different. For the wooden object, they might be a matte. Cotton also look like a matte, but sometimes it's smooth. So you have to merge the lines with the pencils also while applying on applications on a drapery. So you can see on a darkened part, merge these darkened shades with the middle tone and blur some tones with the merging lines. Now I apply some lighter middle tones on a surface to show the roundity of this drapery. The inner depth also are darkened, that I apply with the 4B pencil. First I apply one tone, then finally if we require a more darkened tone, we apply with the 6B pencil. You can see the edge of the folds we darken with the 4B pencils. When drapery is put up on a surface, it gets folded. Also when we put some objects on it, also it gets folded and it gets in a wavy look. So sometime its drapery gets more than 3-4 tones, that we have to show it in a proper manner, that you learn step by step in many assignments. When you practice it more, you get more knowledge about this shading parts. This is your first assignments of pencil shading for the still life, that you learn many techniques of the pencil shading, cross-hatching techniques, also the 2-3 textures of the surface, wooden, cloth and fold, everything you learn in this assignment. Next time when we come, we learn many different objects like steel, glass, metal objects, plastic object, and all the objects has their own identity, own texture, that you have to learn by taking practice at home. I think this is our final steps for the drapery. All folds we are showing in a proper manner. I am showing more details in this object so that you can understand a pencil shadings. The way we apply on a pencil shading on a background, the same way we have to apply it on a foreground also. And now we going to show some darkened tone also, the shadows of the hexagon also. For that we have to take 6B pencil or 4B pencil, directly you can use it. Here is I am showing all the details of the drapery with the pencil shading. Now on the background, on the right hand side part, we start on a shading. Exactly what we done on the left hand side part drapery, we are going to done on the right hand side part. First we apply 2B pencil application with one tone, and for the darkened tone we apply on a 4B pencil tone so that it gets on a darkened tone. Look how I am showing on a darkened tone here. And this drapery has an a fold, overlapping fold on a extreme right hand side part. This also we have to show it by darken the edge of the drapery. Look, I am darken the edge of the drapery, and then by the applications of the pencil shading and with the reference of the light, we showing on a light and dark tone. This is an one application of the pencil shading. There are different applications of the pencil shading that we have to learn in the future. But I am suggest you, this is the perfect technique for your pencil shading technique, and you have to practice at home. Do more practice at home with a different object, different textures of the object, so you can understand these applications of the pencil shading. You can see here, we get all the lights, shades, parts, properly textures of the objects in this pencil shading. This is why this is a perfect pencil shading technique for you. And I hope you understand this assignment very well. Try this at home and learn many drawings with this drawing techniques. Now add some details. Finally, if somewhere we required, and this is our final drawing. Thank you. Best of luck.